हेलो फ्रेंड्स, द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज हाउ कैन इंडिया बिकम ए $5 trillion इकोनॉमी। माय लेसन प्लान इंक्लूड्स व्हाई इज इट इन द न्यूज, द प्रेजेंट स्टेटस ऑफ इंडियन इकोनॉमी, हाउ टू मेक इंडिया ए $5 trillion इकोनॉमी, चैलेंजेस टू इंडियन इकोनॉमी एंड फाइनली कंक्लूजन। फ्रेंड्स, व्हाई इज इट इन द न्यूज, अकॉर्डिंग टू द फोरकास्ट बाय IMF, आई मीन इंटरनेशनल मॉनिटरी फंड, India will become a $5 trillion economy in 2027-28. Although government had fixed the target to achieve $5 trillion economy by 2024, but because of the pandemic corona, the growth rate went into negative, and so now it has been pushed forward to 2027-28. For this, India will have to grow at an average annual growth rate of 6.5% in the next 5 years, between 2023-24 and 2027-28. Making India a $5 trillion economy is the top priority of BJP government. When the BJP government took charge, the size of the Indian economy was $1.85 trillion. In 2022, it is now $3.25 trillion. The focus is on boosting service sector contribution to $3 trillion, manufacturing to $1 trillion, agriculture to $1 trillion. Now I switch over to the present status of Indian economy. Friends, as you know that it is the fifth largest economy of the world by nominal GDP and third largest by purchasing power parity. From 1947 to 1991, successive governments followed protectionist economic policy with extensive state intervention and economic regulation. This was done because of fear of neo-colonialism launched by MNCs. In 1991, the government undertook economic liberalization. Since then, the annual average GDP growth has been 6-7%. The present economy in nominal GDP in 2022 of India is $3.469 trillion and $11.665 trillion in PPP terms, I mean purchasing power parity. Agriculture contributes 16.38% to the GDP, industry 29.3%, and services 54.27%. 42.60% labor are employed in agriculture, 25.12% in industries, and 32.28% labors are employed in services. Main trading partners are US, UAE, China, Bangladesh, Netherlands. Main import partners are China, UAE, I mean United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia. In 2021-22, India exported $421 billion against the imports to the tune of $612 billion. So we see the adverse balance of trade. Now I switch over to another point, how to make India a $5 trillion economy. Number one, boost the middle class by abolishing personal tax could be the biggest stimulus to the economy, making the country an attractive hub for global talent and foreign investment. Contribution of income tax in India is 2.5% of the GDP, corporate tax 25% and GST 50%. Only 2-3% Indians pay income taxes and mostly comprise the salaried class. A loss of 2-3% of the GDP can be compensated by higher indirect taxes. Speed up investment of $1.4 trillion in infrastructure. Government has fixed the target of $1.7 trillion investment in the next 5 years. Dedicated focus on building new cities, ports, bridges, high speed rail, highways will have the multiplying effect on jobs and help reduce unemployment. Boost to the manufacturing sectors by investment in sectors like medical, textiles, smartphones and semiconductors, so that Make in India initiative become a reality. Increasing healthcare spending to the tune of 6% to the GDP. The pandemic corona exposed India's inadequate healthcare infrastructure. BRICS countries, Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa spend 6.3% of their GDP on healthcare. India can provide incentive for doctors and entrepreneurs to set up hospitals in rural areas. Increase ease of the business and ease of living to promote private investment. Over the last 4 years, the government has written off 1300 antiquated laws. It has done away with a lot of archaic procedures, rules and regulation. Through a series of reforms, India has jumped up 65 position the World Bank ease of doing business. The target must be to reach top 50 position the next 2 years. To boost urbanization, friends, as you know that more the urbanization, the more the chances of higher growth. All the advanced countries of the world are highly urbanized. China is also on the path of high level of urbanization. India has just begun to urbanize, and so government has started setting up smart cities. To increase exports, the share of India in global export is less than 2%. So there is a need to increase exports and reduce imports. The unfavorable balance of trade must be mitigated. The unfavorable balance of trade to the tune of $125 billion with China must be reversed. Increase in women participation is key to the growth. Only 26% of women are in workforce in India, while for the world, an average women participation is 48%. South Korea, China and other eastern countries are far ahead to India in women participation in workforce. Agriculture reform is necessary because 42% of Indians are living on income from agriculture. Subsidies will not provide benefits in the long run. Farmers must be acquainted with new technology, better market facilities, fertilizers, pesticides, better quality of seeds, regular irrigation facility to increase productivity. Investment of around $300 billion per year in key infrastructure sectors such as roads, railways, airports, waterways, ports, gas, transport is necessary. It will not just spur economic growth but create enormous scope for environment, income to people and increase in consumption. Given the limitation for government outlay, a substantial chunk of $300 billion investment must come from the private sector. Another requirement will be to promote public-private partnership in the country. The PPP model has not quite worked in India, and so there is need to prop up PPP model to bring more and more investment in our economy. PSEs must be reformed so that they become profit-generating enterprises. Instead of this investment and closure, these PSEs can be made viable by cost-cutting, technology upgradation and better management. To strengthen the MSME sector, there are 6.3 crore MSME enterprises in India and they are providing 11 crore jobs. MSMEs play a critical role across numerous sectors like retail, fashion, food, agribusiness, tourism. The segment suffers from institutional support. Only 16% of MSME get access to credit support. Accelerating the flow of credit to the MSME sector is essential for India to achieve its $5 trillion economy. Challenges to Indian economy. If India is to achieve $5 trillion economy, ex-governor of Reserve Bank Subba Rao said that the challenges are increasing investment, improving productivity, education and health outcomes, creating jobs, raising agriculture productivity, maintaining macroeconomic stability, managing global mega trends and improving governance. He said that Indian economy cannot become 5 trillion unless there is a continuous annual GDP growth of 9% for the next 5 years. Conclusion. Friends, notwithstanding challenges, India continues to be one of the fastest economy of the world. Around $600 billion forex reserves gives the confidence that the country can easily cope up with an external challenges with a Make in India initiative and investor friendly ecosystem. India is going to a 5 trillion economy by 2027-28. India must develop social infrastructure such as health and education to compete with the standard of the world. Every state of India must fix the target of achieving better annual GDP like Maharashtra and Gujarat. Efforts should be made to stop the migration of high net worth people from India to foreign countries, because we know that in 2022, these around 8,000 rich people migrated to other countries. Friends, if you like this lecture, please share and subscribe. And I have written all the details in description box. So please go through. And if you have any suggestion, just write to me. I shall make videos on other topic also as per your suggestion. Thank you very much.